Hello everybody, welcome to Global Cajon. In this chapter we are going to learn how to play some Peruvian styles in the cajon. It's crucial because they are the inventors of this instrument. Enjoy! It was mandatory to have a chapter of this method dedicated to Afro-Peruvian folklore. The Peruvians are the pioneers in playing cajon. They are the inventors of this amazing instrument. I've been in Peru a few times trying to learn the folklore, and I was really amazed with festejo. Festejo is probably the most symbolic style in Afro-Peruvian music. And it's really amazing. It's one of those patterns that has this magic type of subdivision. It's not 16th notes, it's not in triplets, it's somewhere in between. Festejo style and most of Peruvian music that I know, but festejo very in particular, has a very distinguishable characteristic, which is that is continuously flirting with subdividing in triplets or subdividing in 16th notes. And there is not a specific place where it always does one thing or the other. It really depends on the pattern, where they go to more triplet feel or more 16th feel. And that's a characteristic of all the festejo patterns, but you can't really tell where, a general place where they do one thing or the other. For example, this pattern. It sounds like it's starting in three, but then this last part, it's almost ta-ka-ta-ta-ka-ta-ta-ka-ta. It's almost 16th notes. Just to mention the first festejo pattern that came to my mind. So check it out, because that characteristic, regardless of the specifications of each pattern, stays there always in all of festejo patterns. Era de mi gusto casarme con él. And Father McKenzie, lighting the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning the spots in the night that no one has seen. What will he care, all the lonely people? So before going into the specific patterns that I'm going to show you of festejo, we need to practice a few exercises that will help us subdivide as they do, because otherwise the patterns are not going to sound as they are supposed to, okay? So let's do these two exercises to get the flow going. The first exercise we have to do is learn how to subdivide in between 16th notes and triplet. And it's really important that we learn how to have that flow, otherwise the patterns are not going to sound, okay? So it's not takata, 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 takata. That would be in 16th playing 3-4-1, 3-4-1. Takata, 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 takata. It's not takata, 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 takata either. It's not triplets. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Let's see it in the next example.
1, 2, 3, 4.
The second exercise we need to do before going into the specific patterns is a very simple exercise. It's playing the downbeats of the 12-8, okay, the 4-4, ta, 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 with our weak hand, playing the accents, and then subdividing in triplets with our strong hand. That would be right in my case, okay? So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. But this is the important part of the exercise. There's an accent in the 2. This is the first note of the strong hand, okay? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3. Okay, that accent is very important. We are going to use it a lot in the patterns that we're going to see. So let's practice it, separate it, and get the flow. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Festejo has this tiny lick that makes the pattern sound as it's supposed to, but also makes it kind of confusing at the first time because you don't really realize what's going on. That happened to me until I noticed that something weird was happening, and it was all about this little two notes. One of them is a ghost note with our strong hand. Since we play two notes with one particular hand, then the pattern flips over, meaning that you are not playing downbeats with your strong hand anymore. The downbeats are played by your weak hand. I'm going to help you spot that little lick, okay? You go three and there. There, that little note that it's almost, you know, you don't even hear it almost, but you play it. It's super important because otherwise you are going to play always the downbeats with your strong hand and it doesn't sound quite right. Okay, now that we have this magic subdivision for the festejo and we have the accent trained, then we can go to learn the specific patterns that I'm going to show you. Takati tikati tika tokoton, takati tikati tika tokoton, takati tikati tika tokoton, takati tikati tika. Yo no como rocoto con papa, 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 yo no como rocoto con papa. There's a festejo pattern that I like a lot, which is basically the same thing as the previous one, but instead of starting in the downbeat, we start in the upbeat and then go down to the downbeat. Okay? Check it out. 3, 4. Yo no como roco, yo no como roco, yo no como rocoto con papá. Yo no como roco, yo no como roco, yo no como rocoto con papá. Yo no como roco, yo no como roco, yo no como rocoto con papá. Yo no como roco, yo no como roco, yo no como rocoto con papá. Something that I like to do, regardless of the style we are talking about, is playing the specific patterns with one-on-one technique, when that's possible. So we are going to play festejo with one-on-one technique. It's not how they play there, but, you know, music is huge, and you can use this technique for festejo or for other styles. So let's try to do it. Let's play festejo with one-on-one technique.
Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. two, three, four. One, 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 two, three, four. One.
Okay, now we are going to play this pattern that we just learned with the 6-8 clave on our foot, basically for the fun of it, and also our independence. That's very important. I used to do that a lot, to play whatever pattern I just learned, put the clave in it. It's basically the 6-8 clave, but remember, we are not subdividing exactly triplets or exactly 16th, so the clave is not 100% the 6-8, it's a little bit closer to the 4-4 clave. So that, you know, that's the magic part of this type of patterns. Let's check it out. Also, for the fun of it and to train our polyrhythmic skills, we are going to play the same patterns we learned, but instead of playing on our foot or following the pattern with our foot on a 4-4, we are going to do like this. Okay? 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3 versus 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1. Okay? You wouldn't play festejo like that, but maybe you play other things like that. So you need to train that. Let's see. A great coordination exercise that I like to do with festejo is playing whatever pattern of festejo you know on the cajon, and then with your foot switch between doing the downbeats of the 12/8, which is probably the most natural way of feeling the festejo. Also the 6/8 clave, and at last the making groups of four. This really exercises your brain and independence while playing complex things on the cajon and feeling different subdivisions with your foot. Check it out. Well, I hope you enjoyed this chapter. You can find many other chapters of Global Cajon in my YouTube channel. Also, in my website or Facebook, you can see the index to check the chapter that you are interested in. Thanks for being there and see you around. Adios. Mm-hmm.